Milking sheds are great for cows, but they're not usually considered great architecture. They're also not designed for living in. So why would you hire a cowshed specialist to build your dream home? Kentlands are about as far south as you can get in New Zealand, and that's pretty close to the bottom of the world. The area is rugged, isolated, and sparsely populated apart from the rare birds and sea mammals. It's a remote environment and one that's embraced by Lachlan McDonald, who single-handedly runs a 50-acre deer farm in the Kentlands hinterlands. He's a bachelor, but has a plan to change that.
49 years ago, I was born here. As kids, we called that one over there be Werewolf Mountain, because just it's such a weird kind of an outfit with all this kind of bush and stuff on it. But no, up here, this is just called Stony Hill. Not very original, but that's what it is.
After exploring the world in his youth, Lachlan returned to manage the family farm.
You travel the world, you see lots of beautiful sights, but when you come up this valley, it is a pretty special spot.
But the Kentlands can be a harsh place to live. It rains here 150 days a year and is exposed to some bitterly cold weather from the Antarctic to the south. Lachlan has seen out countless winters in the old, cold family farmhouse, but he's had enough.
Well, this house, as you can see, it's probably, I don't know, it's early 1910. But as people full well know, updating an old house, where do you stop? You pull back something, there's something else needs done. So look, probably the most practical thing you could do, really, and the cheapest, well, maybe not the cheapest, is build a new house.
The Deep South is not the sort of place to find flashy real estate, but Lachlan's not one to abide by convention. 6 years ago, he started nurturing a dream to build an architectural home on a site behind the farmhouse, out of something he adores, concrete.
Wow, this is really something.
Even on a poxy day like this, it's pretty good, eh?
Yeah. Tell me a little bit about the site. Why this location? What was special about
it? Well, it was more practical use for the building, because there's a big area here where we can get big concrete trucks and cranes. Plus, it's central to my farm. Like, I'm looking straight across onto that side of the farm. I can then look back that way or look to the east. And then you have this kind of just about perfect pyramid-type hill in front of us here. So it's a pretty nice spot.
What was your brief to the architect?
Open plan living, 4 bedrooms, minimalist style. I want to have a skylight above the bedroom so I can look at the stars at night.
A skylight above the bedroom?
So, other than that, no, and very minimal wood. I just have this dislike of wood. I don't know why. I live out in the country amongst all the trees and stuff. You think I'd like it. I don't. And a flat roof. Dislike pitched roofs. What's a pitched roof about?
I would have thought, standing out here, that a pitched roof could be quite useful. Lachlan's house rails against wood, pitch roofs, and local conventions. Precast concrete panels, rarely seen in the Kentlands, form the walls of a designer farmhouse that cantilevers and soars over the land. There will be 4 pavilions or wings in Lachlan's concrete home. The first will contain his bedroom, an ensuite, a guest room, and a garage. A walkway will lead to a second wing with 2 more bedrooms and a shared bathroom. A 3rd pavilion will house a generator and battery room. The front door will open to a window framing Werewolf Mountain. The living area features a sharply angled wall made of, you guessed it, concrete. In a brief concession to wood, Lachlan's agreed to a kitchen roof and wall of bandsawn macrocarpa, all topped with one of the flattest roofs in Southland, an extraordinary modernist masterpiece for a bachelor pad on a remote farm.
I mean, it's not like the average house in the Kentlands, is it?
No, but I never set out to be different. I was just doing what I like. No, I don't think it's going to be too foreign to this site because of all the rock and the colour that we have in behind us, the greys.
Four bedrooms. Why four bedrooms? I mean, there's only one of you.
Well, Chris, that is correct, but I am building for a future family, perhaps.
So the house is designed for the family?
Yes, the future family.
But they're not here yet?
No, but they will turn up. It's just a case of actually finding that woman in the world.
So that's the next project?
Yeah, that project has been ongoing for some time.
Lachlan's never built a house from scratch before, so he's asked a mate to help him out. Kevin De Groot's built a couple of houses, but spends most of his working life making dairy sheds.
Kevin has built 100 cow sheds. Question for me is he the man to build Lachlan's dream home? G'day, Lachlan.
Hello, Chris, how you doing?
Nice to see you again.
This is Kevin the Builder.
Chris, how are you?
G'day, Kevin.
Yeah.
So, tell me, Lachlan, why did you choose Kevin?
I chose Kevin because he's the man of concrete.
Man of concrete?
Yes, in 1 year, he uses 400 truckloads of concrete.
400 trucks?
Mm. So, on my particular house, how many concrete loads will be there, Kevin?
Maybe 30, 40. Yeah.
So, there you go.
Kevin plans to build Lachlan's house during the dairy shed downtime, a four-month window over spring and early summer. It seems a reasonable turnaround, as long as things are well managed and contractors' items are on time.
Project management, that's a critical issue in terms of the build. Who's going to be responsible for that?
Well, naively, I'm going to be the project manager as such, but Kevin will most certainly be the man that I'll be talking to the most. He's built houses, I haven't.
Well, that's going to be a learning experience.
Oh, hell yeah.
are you up for that, Kevin?
Oh, yeah, it'd be great, yeah.
It's all smiles now, guys. And I'm just thinking, being a project manager, this is a serious job. I mean, quite a bit of a challenge there.
Oh, come on, Chris. You were just building a house. It's nothing too major. What can go wrong?
Well, in my experience, quite a lot, actually.